All right, Rob, we learned this week Kevin McCarthy resigning at the end of the year. We spoke to the head of the California Republican Party prior to our conversation, and I asked her the question, you know, how is this going to affect the races in 2024 and really California as a whole? You know, Kevin McCarthy was a prolific fundraiser. That was his reputation. Even though he says he's going to be involved, it's not the same thing when you're out of office and not holding that position of power.
Yeah, look, for the last decade and a half, Kevin McCarthy's been the most powerful Republican in California, and he has used that position of power to be the primary patron of the California Republican Party. He's been very involved in fundraising. Sure, I think he will continue to be, but you're never as powerful a fundraiser as you are out of office as when you're in office. So I do think California Republicans are moving into a new era, a post-McCarthy era, but that doesn't necessarily, we don't know what it means yet. It doesn't necessarily mean that power will wane. There may be new people that step up into leadership roles.
How do you think this shakes out for all these close House races in 2024?
I don't think it specifically affects the close House races. They'll all be funded well. It could affect the Republicans' effort across the country. I mean, you do have to consider that McCarthy was a superior fundraiser to Speaker Johnson. It's a superior political operation that Johnson's now trying to take over. But look, in the margins, this could hurt the Republicans nationally on extending the map and becoming more competitive and trying to knock out vulnerable Democrats.
All right, so let's talk about his district as a whole. This is a statewide show, so we have people all around the state that might not be familiar with Kevin McCarthy's district. And let's be honest, he is a punching bag nationally in the media and you know, kind of seen as maybe not a popular national figure among both Republicans and Democrats. We saw the ouster of him in the House, but in his district, he's beloved still.
Yeah, look, Kevin McCarthy's the favorite son of Kern County. And by the way, this is about the most Republican district in the state of California. So it's a very red seat. But McCarthy's popular back home. In fact, who he ends up endorsing for the seat will probably have a real advantage with the voters.
Who do you see as, you know, the favorite right now? We've, you know, seen a couple of names floated. Vince Fong, who was talked about in circles as sort of his heir apparent because he was a mentor. But he has said this week that he is not going to run. So who do you think would be a good person?
Well, of the sitting office holders there over the seat, with Fong deciding not to run and run again for the assembly, Senator Shannon Grove sticks out as an obvious choice. Someone would have a real advantage. The districts are almost identical to one another, the way they overlay. And she has what we call a free ride. She's in a four-year Senate term that doesn't expire for two more years. So she could run without jeopardizing her current office.
Okay, so let's sort of talk about not the impact of this on a California level, because we had these two powerful figures in Northern California. It was Nancy Pelosi. You know, down, you mentioned the son of Kern County, it was Kevin McCarthy. And their names were very on the marquee, you know, in Washington, D.C., hailing from the state of California. It just feels like it's the end of an era right now.
Yeah, look, this is a real blow to California power. Obviously, the Pelosi era of reign is over. So's the McCarthy era. You know, even in a large zoom back out and realize that we've lost Senator Feinstein, obviously, in this past year. So what has traditionally been the power center of for Californians in both parties has really now turned over. And it's going to be time to look to new, you know, power centers. Pete Aguilar, congressman from San Bernardino, is number three, I believe, in the House Democrat structure. So you'll start to see new people emerge. But there's no question things will never quite be the same with the rivalry between San Francisco and Kern County now waning. And it was that rivalry that really wielded a lot of power for the state for many years.
All right, we will leave it there. Rob Stutzman, we appreciate your time on Inside California Politics, as always.
My pleasure.